Hello students, welcome to Top Scholars. Let's learn about something that has become one of the biggest threats to our planet and its environment, that is global warming. In this video, you will get to know what is global warming, greenhouse effect, causes of global warming, effects of global warming. So, let's start. In simple words, global warming is a rise in the temperature. This is happening due to many factors. You must have heard of news like the melting of the glaciers, the increase in diseases like skin cancers, etc., right? These are all the consequences of global warming. It is so harmful that the entire human race can end. Therefore, it is very important to understand how global warming works. Let's know what the greenhouse effect is and how it affects the rise in temperature. The greenhouse effect is a primary concept when trying to understand global warming. You might think it's a bad thing since it's related to global warming, right? But it's not. Without the greenhouse effect, living on this planet would not be possible for us. It occurs naturally on the Earth and it keeps the Earth warm so that we can survive. Let's understand it by looking at a real greenhouse. It is a small house made up of glass that is used to grow plants during winter. It was created in such a way that it lets the light in but does not allow the heat to escape so that the plants can grow. On Earth, the sun is constantly radiating light towards us. The clouds we have reflect 1/4 of this radiation and they absorb some of it. Due to this, around 50% of the sun's radiation falls on Earth. Now, our Earth is also playing its part here. Earth's surface reflects back heat, but clouds trap it due to greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, methane, and sulfur dioxide. These gases prevent heat from escaping, causing the heat to return to the Earth. This system was working well to create a pleasant atmosphere on Earth. However, now, due to the activities of man, the amount of greenhouse gases has increased much more than required. Therefore, Earth is heating up way too much. Too much heat in our food burns it, right? So naturally, the heat on our Earth is harming plants, humans, water bodies, and everything inside the environment. In the past century, Earth's temperature has increased by around 0.6 degrees Celsius. Let's look at the causes of global warming in brief. There are natural causes too. They are, number one, volcanoes. The emission of smoke and ash during the volcanic eruption spreads out in the atmosphere and causes global warming. Water vapor. This is a type of greenhouse gas too. The rise in Earth's temperature causes evaporation of water, which gets accumulated in the atmosphere and helps in trapping heat. Next, melting permafrost. It is frozen soil that is situated below the Earth's surface. Permafrost is present in glaciers. When it melts, it releases gases into the atmosphere, leading to an increase in the Earth's temperature. But the man-made causes are harming much more. They are release of chlorofluorocarbon. Large-scale use of refrigerators and air conditioners depletes the ozone layer, increasing Earth's temperature due to harmful ultraviolet rays entering the Earth's surface. Next, deforestation. Trees and plants are the best sources of oxygen. This is getting depleted due to large-scale cutting of trees. Excessive use of motor vehicles that run with the help of fossil fuels and emit carbon dioxide. All of this causes so much damage. Let's see some of them. Damage to coral reef. There is a loss of animal and plant lives. Various climatic imbalances, like some areas faces floods while some others suffers from drought, which are the immediate results of global warming. Fluctuating patterns of heat and humidity causing increased diseases like malaria and dengue. increased number of natural calamities like earthquakes, floods, and tsunamis. Migration of animals to other places for their survival, which causes their extinction in the process sometimes. The issue of global warming has been discussed several times by many international organizations, but only a few organizations manage to bring about a positive change into action. However, by spreading awareness among the people and launching small campaigns, we can make a mark towards preventing global warming. With this, we have come to an end of this topic. Let's look at some questions now. First, what are some of the greenhouse gases? Why is water vapor a greenhouse gas? How does ozone protect Earth from harmful rays? What are some of the causes of global warming? What is the basic meaning of global warming? With this, we have come to an end. Thank you.